In this video, we are going to take a look at adding fillets in the feature mode. You may remember that we can add fillets to a sketch, but it works much better if you add them as features. They're much easier to modify and delete if you decide you want to get rid of them. Filleting in the feature mode also allows you to fillet in multiple directions, not just whatever direction the sketch is created in. The fillet command is located here on the 3D model tab in the modify panel. You can also type F at your keyboard to start the command. And there's lots of different options for the fillet command. We'll look at several of them. We won't necessarily look at every single one though at this point in time. So first you'll notice that I start out on the constant tab and then I have edge fillet selected. It's asking me right now to go out and select edges and then I can specify a radius. So I'll go ahead and come in here and just pick one single edge for now. I can come in here and modify the fillet value. Let's go back down to maybe a quarter inch for that one. And then I can go ahead and click OK. So really easy to add just a single edge fillet. I'm going to undo and start that again. And look at some other options that I have here. First of all, I can select multiple edges. So if I wanted to select around the top, I can continue clicking multiple edges and then click OK when I'm done. I'm going to back that up again here and show you that I can do multiple fillet sizes in the same command. So once more, I can come back in and select those four top edges. And then let's say I wanted to fillet the top of this little prism 1/8 of an inch. So I'm going to click in the row where it says click to add. I'll put in a new fillet value here of 0.125, and you can see the pencil still here, meaning I'm editing. So I just have to come over and click on the pencil to switch back to the select mode. And now you can see that I can select multiple edges here, and then I can go ahead and click OK. Now this is probably a user preference, but personally, if I'm going to do two different size fillets, I prefer to do them in completely different commands so that way I have completely different entries over here in my model browser. If I wanted to just get rid of the smaller ones, I'd have to go in and edit the fillet. I can double click on it or right click and edit feature. And then I'd have to come in here and do some modifications for this one. I'll just press delete at my keyboard. So as I was saying, I would prefer to do that in a completely separate fillet. That way, if I look over here at my model browser, I've got fillet 1 for those larger ones and fillet 2 for the smaller ones, and it's much easier to modify or delete those if needed. I'm going to back up once more and take a look at some of the other selection methods when we're filleting. Over here to the right, you can see that it's set to edge. I can switch it to loop. And so with loop, it's going to pick a chain of lines that are connected at their endpoints. Now, if it is a tangent curve, it should pick it automatically. We'll look at that in just a moment. This will be a loop of edges that join at their endpoints. As you can see, I'm wanting the top, and I keep getting the front face just depending on where I hold my mouse. If you don't get exactly what you want, you can hover there for a moment until the Select Other tool pops up, and then choose the specific loop that you want. So there you can see I was able to go ahead and select them all using the loop option. Back up one more time, do the fillet again, and this time I'm going to choose the feature option. So a feature is one of these things over in my model tree. I've got two features right now, extrusion 1 and extrusion 2. If I come in and click extrusion 1, you can see that it's going to fillet or round every corner of that shape. Back up again and do this one more time. This time for the feature, I'll choose my second prism. You can see that it filleted all of the edges except around the bottom because it joins to this other part. So it doesn't actually grab those. But it also gives me a chance to show you that when you fillet, if you have tangent edges, those edges will be selected automatically. So you can see I'm in edge mode, but it's going to go ahead and pick up all those edges since they are all tangent there. And then as always, I can come back in and modify these fillet radius values as needed. So I'm going to go a little smaller on these. That looks a little better. I'm going to back up once again and look at a couple more selection methods. We have the ability to select all fillets and all rounds. So technically we do this all with the same fillet command, but technically, fillets are inside corners and rounds are outside corners. So you can see when I select fillets, it just selects these inside corners here. Rounds is going to be all of the outside corners. And again, I can modify these values as needed, but you can see that it does pick every single edge throughout the whole part, regardless of how many features there are. Next, we'll take a look at the ability to create a variable radius fillet. I will begin my fillet command and switch to the variable tab, then select an edge. As you can see right now, I've got a quarter inch radius value and it's given me a start and an end value. I can adjust the end value. And as you can see, it's just going to transition gradually from a quarter inch radius to a half inch radius. I can also add new points along the way. So I'll set those both back to a quarter inch. So I'm going to click inside the dialog box here. Then I can come out and add in another point. So I really want to go right in the middle. I can actually see my midpoint snap there. So I can go ahead and click there. And then just for the heck of it, I'm going to also add one at the quarter mark and the 3/4 mark. So I don't have anything to snap to here. I'm just going to kind of eyeball these. And then if I come back up to my dialog box, you can see that basically I have 0 to 1. The start is 0, the end is 1. So then halfway along the length is 0.5. So you don't really have to even know how long the edges are. You can just put in essentially a percentage. I want to be 0.25 into the part there and 0.75 into the part there. Now, if at any point in time you see this UL, that just stands for unitless. It's letting us know that that's not 0.5 inches or millimeters. It's just simply 0.5. Now I can adjust my fillet radius values. So I can say, for example, at the halfway mark, I want that to be, we'll say 0.5. Then I can control these other values as well. So maybe at the 25% mark, I want it to be 3/8. And then same thing at the 75% mark as well. Then I can go ahead and click OK. And then once more, you can see the different varying fillets along that part. The last thing we will look at is the ability to add a full round fillet. I'm going to completely round the side of this part. I'm going to use my fillet command and choose the full round fillet option. Now the thing about this one is it doesn't ask me for a radius value because the radius value is going to be driven by how wide this part is. It first asks me to select a side face. So I'll select this face here. Then it asks me for the center face. So I'll pick this face here. Then finally, it asks me for my other side face. So I'll pick the opposite side here. And as you can see, it added a full round. Once more, I didn't have to put in a radius value. It was calculated based upon how big the part was. So let's see that one more time. Fillet, full round. I'll pick one side, then the center face, then the opposite side, and you can see that the full edge has been rounded. And then one more reminder, since I have tangent edges, remember that if I come back in and fillet an edge, it's going to pick up the entire loop there for me. To recap, several different options in the fillet command. Again, we can specify our edge and our radius values, several different selection methods, including edge, loop, feature, all fillets, and all rounds. We also have the ability to vary the fillet radius. And finally, we can do a full round to completely round one side of a part. That concludes this look at adding fillets in Autodesk Inventor.